Good morning. How is everyone today? It is my Monday. Well, a lot of people's Monday since yesterday was Labor Day. Let me think. I'll start with a question. When is a good time for everybody for me to pop on and do a few things? You know, makeup, tutorials, that kind of thing. What's good for people? So we had one heck of a week in our family. It doesn't happen but once a year. Once a year. Sometimes twice. It just depends. We're all together. It does not happen often. And so when it does, by the time the week's over, you're exhausted and tired. So you know you got all this stuff to do at home and you just like, meh, nah, I'll get to it later. So good morning, everybody. I've got a work day today. I'm gonna go BB cream today for makeup with my kabuki brush. This is the kabuki brush from our vegan line, which I love the bristles of it. It's so soft, but it puts your makeup on very nicely. But if you're popping on, say hello, please. Say hi. Who's watching? That kind of thing. So anyway, everybody, my sisters that live away came home. It's kind of funny because that used to be me and Jerry. We were the ones that came home. And, you always planned get-togethers, barbecues. Hi, boo-boo. You always planned get-togethers, barbecues, that kind of thing. Well, this visit, we had a wedding. So after about 10 years, I think it's right at 10 years together, my brother got married. Him and Tracy, about 10 years. Small ceremony. Another cool thing is my sister Gina married them. She's got that magic internet ability to marry people. And I really think she enjoys doing it. My sister Carol came in from Florida. And two of her daughters came home this time. Becca and Luke come in with their little boy Cal. And they come in from Colorado Springs. And then Carol's daughter, Sabra, lives in Missouri now, and she came home for the wedding. Actually, it was probably great because killed two birds with one stone. She got to see her mom, and she got to go to the wedding and see her other sister. She's got two sisters, but one couldn't come in, so we got Becca that was here from Colorado. So Carol got to visit with her daughters, visit with her sisters, visit with her brother. I think she even got to go visit some old friends. So, sorry, I had a message. I wanted to look at it real quick. It made for had a busy week at work. I worked But we spent a day at the zoo. A really weird day at the zoo with only having one child with us because the kids have started school. So it was kind of strange to do that. But it was fun. You find out how old you're getting when you walk those hills at the zoo. And but a lot of stuff was open. You didn't have to get a reservation. Well, you had to get a reservation to go to the zoo, but you didn't have to have a reservation to go into the penguin house and stuff. The last time we went, you had to have a reservation. So anyway, we spent a day there. And then I don't think I saw him again until Saturday at the wedding. I think that's the next time I saw everybody. And it was a night full of music. Thank you to Gina's wife. She did the DJing. She does that on the side for a living. And I'm sure the people down in the restaurant part of the place was thinking the building was coming down because we had a lot of little kids dancing and trying to twerk. I'll say trying to twerk. It was hilarious. I think there's even some video out there of this attempt. So, but you know how it goes. Once one person hits the dance floor, everybody hits the dance floor. So it turned into, the wedding was at 5. We ate, and then it was dancing the rest of the night. And sore legs and praying you were going to be able to get down those steep stairs at the end of the night. Because it was in a very old building. And, you know, in the old days, they built straight up. They didn't build at angles, like big angles, but it was steep. But we did it and celebrated with John and Tracy for their wedding. And lots of, like I said, lots of great music, lots of old music. And you think you're down on the floor, the dance floor, and next thing you know, they play another song that you're like, oh, I gotta dance to that song. So, a little eye primer. So anyway, so we boogied the night away, but I think we were all still gone by 9 o'clock. No joke. We were all gone. No, not all of us. I think the bridegroom, the DJ, Gina, well, DJ Kim, Gina, John's friend, and maybe a couple more was still there. That was it. Us middle-aged people beat it. We were out of there. It was time to go home. My husband, when he gets around Gina Lynn and he gets around, well, my brother, they feed him alcohol and bourbon. I'm not talking beer. And Jerry loves a good bourbon. And he, I still feel like I got a blint on my nose. I'll put some powder on it. So, you know, you got that going on. So, then you're worried about getting him down the stairs at the end of the night. So, parents of small children paid for it. The next morning when the kids are up bright and early and you're staring at them like they've lost their mind. But that wasn't me. I was good. I got to, I can't even think if I slept in or not. But, anyway, we all got together Sunday and ate and visited and watched them open, their presents that they had at the wedding. And I think I'm just going to go super subtle today. I'll say that and then regret it. So we pulled up lawn chairs. It was a gorgeous day Sunday, and we visited all afternoon. sat outside. We ate pulled pork and breakfast and dessert, and they talked and told stories, and it was a good afternoon. And I was finally, I'm the one looking at my husband going, it's time to go. Again, they got a hold of my husband with drinking. And I think he had a great time this weekend. 'Cause, I don't know, they can swap stories. They can, you know, they all visit, and getting to see the sister you don't see but once a year, and the sister that you might see, you know, pending how busy she is, a couple times a year. And yes, the road goes both ways. We do need to make a trip to see you. That used to be our theme song, The Road Goes Both Ways. So, we will go visit. But, you know, you do that get together, and it's wonderful. It's a nice feeling to see family. And let's put some warm, it's called Warm Teddy. We're just going to put a touch of that on here. I'm in the glam up palette today. Again, my favorite. I don't veer very far from that one. So anyway, you got that. And then, the trip to the airport to drop Carol off in the morning yesterday and saying bye, which is hard to do. But, then, you know, you spend the afternoon dealing with, I don't know if anybody else has an SBC Global account, but, I don't think they truly exist anymore. If you've got one, you've got it. Otherwise, you have to literally, I couldn't come up with my password for my SBC Global account, because my email account, because I don't use that account hardly ever. And problem is I do have a lot of things on there that, like, for instance, my Venmo account. And that's another long, stupid story. But I needed to get into my Global account so this dude on the phone could combine the two accounts that I had of Venmo, because I put in the wrong email address and I typoed a phone number so it actually let me do it. Anyway, long story, hard to explain. So I can't get to some money that's sitting in there that is payment for an order. I can't get to it. Now it's just dealing with the bank. I got to call the bank today and get them on it. They've got to get in there and Venmo wants their security precaution. So I thought I'd use the debit to do that and just make it easier. Well, my bank flagged it as possible fraud, you know, somebody getting into my account. So, they were closed yesterday. The only good thing that came out of that whole yesterday afternoon, where I was saying words I don't say a lot of, yes, I do say them, but not near as much. But when I'm pissed, they come out, but the lady I had on the phone with me from AT&T was fantastic. I'll give you that. I got a good one. And they got like 100 numbers to call. And the dude I had first couldn't help me, but he moved me over to this lady that was able to reset my password for my SBC Global account. And the bummer is, when I got back to that, I couldn't find the email the guy sent me, which is weird. So anyway, we round and round, playing with the kids and, you know, good afternoon. I mean, we had a good afternoon. I'm going to attempt to smudge thing real quick. I'm going to smudge, to make your eyes look bigger, I'm going to smudge a little. I'm going to use shadow instead of liner under my eye. Guess I could. No. Because I'm not going to use an ink liner today. I'm just going pretty neutral, pretty simple, nothing major. I need my little flat. That guy. I want this guy. See? So, because he'll do a straight line. I'm just going to tap it on the brush, and I'm going to go right under my eye. I probably shouldn't pull on my eye, but the thing is if you want your eyes to look bigger, what I'm learning is you need to smudge your liner underneath your eye, okay? And don't put it so thick on the top. Put a nice fine line on the top if you want to wear it on the top. And ta-da, you get a bigger looking eye. I'll have to do a training on that, not a training, a video on that, and see what you guys think of the result. But I'm not one to put a lot under my eye. Usually just my mascara, and half the time I don't do that because allergies. Stupid allergies. So anyway, long story short, it was like a nightmare, okay? But then I had to go to Walmart and get stuff for supper. I could not buy, mind you, this is an eyebrow brush, but I used it for that, so you got the thing on the end. You can use your powders to do your eyebrows, and you make your nice lines, and then you take your brush and smooth it. And I haven't used my eyebrow wax today. So, anyway, but that's the glam palette that I put on. And I'm going to put a little primer on. And then I think I'm going to use my Extreme Curl mascara today. I had good results with that Saturday night when I got ready for the wedding. I had really good results from that. And yes, it was still there Sunday morning when, because I did not take my makeup off like a bad person. So anyway, so we just, I went to Walmart and dealt with those people. I don't like that phrase, those people, but they weren't too bad, but it was busy. And you couldn't buy one whole chicken. You had to buy two. But I have to say the price was pretty good. But I made beer can chicken last night on the smoker. I don't mess often with Jerry's smoker. It scares me. It's something about not having that flame under the meat. But I season it on the outside. I marinate it inside with garlic butter. And then that's just primer that I use. I'm hoping to see one of those come out with pharmacy. But actually, I'm going to switch to Starluck. I'm going to use Starluck. Starluck has that unique brush. So, but anyway, everybody, especially Remington, seemed to love the chicken. And it had a nice, it was juicy and it tasted good. And, but the sick child does not like, I've got a hair that's, does not like fried potatoes. I'm not sure who out there does not like fried potatoes. Yeah, they're bad for you. But he will not eat fried potatoes. I'm not even sure if he'll eat mashed potatoes even. I know he'll touch French fries, but then he doesn't eat a lot of French fries. See, Starluck helps with that side, getting those lashes up and off. But you got to be careful or you wind up with it everywhere. So anyway, so that came out of the night tasting really good, which was great. but just dealing with customer services. And then with my short-term memory issues, I had trouble remembering how to get back in to my email for SBC Global. And it hit me in the middle of the night what I should have done, because I couldn't figure out why it wouldn't pop up when I went back to it. And then I figured it out in the middle of the night. But it was a good weekend. It was a busy, busy weekend. I didn't accomplish anything I wanted to do. Yard work with this beautiful weather. I had yard stuff I wanted to get done. And that, pray God, is Thursday that I do that. I get that done. It takes my no lashes to lashes. But anyway, so as you can see, I smudged that under there. And it is supposed to make your eyes, it does make your eyes look bigger. But I don't like to put a lot under there. I'm going to try a darker color one day and see how that goes. There's some cool tricks you can do to keep from getting mascara on top of your lid, which I'm usually, I call it white out. I'll put it on where I've missed, but I'm not going to do that today. I don't feel like it. So, but anyway, so it was a good weekend. I'm going to put my peach blush on. Pretty peach. Nice and soft, subtle. I don't like a lot of color on my cheeks because I am naturally pink toned. So I tend to veer from a whole lot. But anyway, while I'm finishing up this, I luckily have time today to mess around with this, but pharmacy finally has their website up and running. It's beautiful. It's a heck of a lot easier to manage, to find your way around the site, even as a customer. We've introduced a new skincare line, which I'm going to talk about, at some point this week. I'm going to talk about this new skincare line, which I myself cannot wait to try with being 50. I'm getting ready to turn 55 years old, and I'm going to take some bronzer. And you, as you age, you know, you lose the elasticity in your skin. I lost everybody already today. It's early. It's Tuesday. People are working. And I'm getting ready to go to work. I need to come on tonight. Maybe I'll do that. I'll do that tonight before Jared gets off work. I know Trisha's got two kids with... Oh, no. Just one kid with ball practice tonight. And then we have a makeup football game tomorrow night. So I do that under here to shadow that little pocket that I'm working on with my age reverses serum and stuff. It'll help firm that. Another great product we have that'll help firm that is our chili balsam, or chili pepper and paprika balsam. I say it backwards. And that's really great. So after time, right? Won't do it in a day. It won't do it in a week. You've got to apply it every day. And ladies are seeing results in firming of this, firming of the stomach, firming of the underarm by using this paprika and chili balsam. So I'll have to do something about talking about that again. But I thought that was really cool that they were seeing results from that. Mine isn't huge yet, but it's getting there. But this new skincare line is made for people over the age of 35. It's made for older skin. So in other words, it's got everything in it you need to help with aging skin. So you can use that. I think I'll go with confident today, just slightly. But it's called Resurface. It is a higher quality, I guess, even more with what the contents it has in it, I can see why. Higher end, there's the word I'm looking for, skincare line. That is going to make magic with your face, your skin in general. I've seen mass improvement in my skin just with Age Reversist. So I can't imagine what the Resurface line is going to do for me. I do have some back posts where I talk about it or show you the pics of it. I need to study a little more on the collagen. It's got retinol, which is great for helping with those fine lines and wrinkles, because retinol will go in and it takes off that dead skin off of your face, which freshens your skin. Okay. It's one of the best things for that is retinol. And your collagen, it'll fill in those fine lines or plump your skin. Speaking of plumping skin, our new concealers that have been introduced, don't have them yet. They have the ability to plump your skin. So basically they will go in and they will puff, like if you put it on your eye, it's going to puff that out here to help take away from fine lines and wrinkles. Wherever you need it, it's going to plump that skin and make it better, like a lip plumper almost that I just put on. So anyway, I will let y'all go. I've bored you enough and I'm going to get ready for work. It's that time of day. And go on, take a look at the new website. It's gorgeous and user-friendly. And one of the amazing things about pharmacy is it's a free website. So I love it. And you can become a customer for free. You can become a BI for $20, people. And if you've been a BI before and you want to reactivate, right now it's free. You don't have to pay the $19.99 again if you are inactive. It is free to rejoin. So I'm going to go. Everybody have a great Tuesday, and I hope it is a beautiful day for you. Bye.